Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class, we had started with the chapter multiplication, correct? So we saw what is multiplication. So multiplication is defined as to calculate the result of repeated addition of two numbers, correct? So multiplication is defined as repeated addition of two numbers. Now we saw that the number which is being multiplied is called the multiplicand, correct? The number which you are multiplying is called a multiplicand, and the number with which it is multiplied, it is called a multiplier. Okay, the answer obtained is known as product. So the answer that you get when you multiply two numbers, it is called as the product. Then we saw the different tables from 1 to 10. So we saw tables from 1 to 10, correct? So tables you get by multiplying two numbers, finding the product of two numbers, you get these tables. So we went through the tables, and then we saw what are the properties of multiplication. What are the properties of multiplication? First property of zero. So when any number is multiplied with zero, the result is always zero. So whenever you multiply a number with zero, you get the result as zero itself. Okay, so that's the first property. Then second property of 1. When a number is multiplied with 1, the result is the number itself. Okay, so when you multiply any number with 1, the result is the number itself. So 5 into 1 is equal to 5, they're told. Okay, so first two properties of 0. When you multiply a number with 0, the result is always 0. When you multiply a number with 1, the result is the number itself. Okay, then order property. So order property is the product of two or more numbers is the same, whatever be the order in which they are multiplied. So when you're multiplying two or more numbers together, you can multiply these numbers in any order. You multiply them in any order, your product will remain the same. Okay, the product remains same in whichever order you multiply the numbers. Then multiplication with 10, 100 and 1000. When a number is multiplied with 10, 100 and so on, the product of the product is the number itself followed by the same number of zeros as in the multiplier. Now here 4 into 10, 10 is a multiplier. So we'll write 4 as it is, and in multiplier we have 1 0, so we'll follow 4 with 1 0 for 40. 4 into 100 we'll write 4, and in 100 we have 2 zeros, so we'll write 2 zeros after 4, so 400. Okay, then 4 into 1000 also same, we'll write 4, and in 1000 we have 3 zeros, so we'll put 3 zeros after 4, so it becomes 4000. Okay, so this is multiplication with 10, 100 and 1000. So these are the four properties of multiplication that we learnt. So in today's class, what we'll be doing? We'll be doing multiplication by one digit numbers. Okay, we'll do multiplication by one digit numbers. So multiplying by a one digit number is very simple if you know the multiplication tables. So if you know the tables, it will be very easy to multiply numbers. Okay, you will have to regroup and carry over wherever the value in any place exceeds 9. So same as in addition, whenever you add two numbers, if the added value is exceeding 9, okay, in that place, then you carry over to the next place. So in multiplication also we do the same. Okay, so study these examples to understand different ways of multiplication. So they have asked, what is 3 times 32? So what we'll do, we'll multiply 32 with 3. So there are two methods. First is the box type multiplication. So how do you do box type multiplication? Now 32 will write like this. 32 will expand and write it as 30 and 2. Okay, and here we have 3. So multiply 10s and 1s separately. So we separate 32 as 1s, 10s and 1s. Then we multiply it separately. So first we'll multiply 3 with 30. 3 into 30 is how much? It is 90. And then we multiply 3 with 2. 3 2s is how much? It is 6. Okay, now we have 90 here and 6. So you add the result. So 90 plus 6 is 96. So 32 into 3 is 96. So your solution looks like this. 3 into 30, 90. 3 into 2, 6. So 90 plus 6, 96. Okay, so now here method 2, there's another method. So you write like this in place values. So 32 in 1s, 2, 10s, 3, and 3 here we write it in 1s place and we put the multiplication sign, which is a cross mark. Okay, so now 32 here is called the multiplicand, 3 is the multiplier. And the product, how will you find 3 2s is how much? First you multiply 3 with the 1s place. So 3 2s is 6. So we'll write 6 in 1s place. And we'll multiply with the tens. 3 threes is how much? 3 threes is 9. So we'll write 9 in the tens place. So the product is 96. Okay, so these are the two methods of multiplication. Box type multiplication, and this is the another method. So we'll find, let's see a few more examples and then we'll solve the questions in the textbook. So find the product of 27 and 2. So box type mode will do 20 and 7 will separate. So we'll multiply 2 with 20 first, we get 40. Then we'll multiply 2 with 7, we get 14. Now what we do, we add 40 and 14, which will 40 plus 14 is 54. So your answer will be 54. Okay, then method 2. So here we'll write in your place values, then we'll multiply. 2 7s are 14, so write 4, carry over 1. Okay, then 2 2s are 4 plus 1 is 5, so 54. Okay, now here we are multiplying a 3 digit number with a single digit number. So 212 into 4. So here we'll separate hundreds, tens and ones. So 212 becomes 200 plus 10 plus 2. So first we'll multiply 4 with 200. When you multiply, you get 800. Then we'll multiply 4 with 10. 4 tens are 40. Then 4 with 2, we get 8. So we'll add all the 3, 800 plus 40 plus 8, so you get 848. Now using this method, we write it in their place values. So 2 in 1s, 1 in 10s, 2 in 100s and 4 in 1s place. So first we multiply 4 with 2. So when you multiply 4 with 2, you get 8. Then 4 with 1, you get 4. And 4 with 2, you get 8. So 848. Alright, so next example is also similar, 345 with 6. So here first we expand 345 as 300 plus 40 plus 5. Then we multiply it with 6. So 6 into 300 you'll get, now what you do, 6 3s are you multiply first, you'll get 18. And then write the 2 zeros from 300, so you'll get 1800. Then 6 into 40, so 6 4s are 24 and 1 0, 240. And 6 5s are is 30. So now we add 1800 plus 240 plus 30, we'll get 2070. Okay, so that was box type method. Then using the other method, we'll write it in your place value chart. So 6 5s are, first we'll multiply with the 1s. So 6 5s is 30, so it's exceeding 9. So we'll write 0 and carry over 3. Okay, then 6 4s is how much? 6 4s is 24. 24 plus 3 is 27. Again, it is exceeding 9, so we'll write 7 and carry over 2 here. Then 6 3s are 18 and 18 plus 2 is 20. So 2070 is the answer. Okay, so this is how you do multiplication. Now, okay, so these are the various examples of multiplication. Now, 1, 2, 4, 3 into 2. So first we'll multiply with the 1s. So here now we have a 4 digit number. So instead of using the box type method, we'll use only the second method. So 2 3s are 6. Then we'll multiply with tens. 2 into 4 is 8. So we'll write 8. Then 2 into 2 is 100. Sorry, 2 into 2 is 4. So we'll write 4. And 2 into 1 is 2. So 2 4 8 6 is the answer. Or you can write like this also. 2 into 3 1s is 6. 2 into 4 tens will get 8 tens. So that is 80. 2 into 200s you get 400, so that you write 400. 2 into 1000 is 2000. So when you add all of the above, you'll get 2486. Okay, similarly this example also, 2986 into 7. So 7 6 are 42, we write 2 and carry over 4. Then 7 8s are 56 plus 4 60, so write 0, carry over 6. 7 9s are 63 plus 6 is 69, so we write 9, carry over 6. And 7 2s are 14 plus 6 20, so 20,902. Or 7 into 6 1s 42, 7 into 8 10s 540, 7 into 900, 6300, and 7 into 2000, 14000. So, any all that you'll get, add all that, you'll get 20,902. Okay, so now we'll solve a few problems. Okay, so exercise 4.2 on page number 128. Okay, so let's solve. First is they've given box type method, so let's do those. So 21 into 4. Now 21 they have separated as 20 and 1 into 10s and 1s. So what you'll do first? Now you'll do 4 into 20. So now you know 4 2s is 8 and 1 0 is there. So we'll put 1 0. So 4 2s are 80. And 4 1s is how much? 4 1s is 4. So 80 and 4. So 21 into 4 is how much? It is 80 plus 4. Okay, 80 plus 4 is how much? It is 84. So first answer is 84. Okay, so the next one. Now here they have told 33 into 2. So first we'll write the multiplier, which is 2 here. Then we'll write, now we'll 33 into 10s and 1s will be 30 and 3. Correct, 30 and 3. So 2 into 30, when you do what you'll get, 2 3s is how much? 2 3s is 6 and 1 0, so 60. And 2 3s again is 6. So 60 plus 6. So here we have 60 plus 6, which will be 60. 6. Okay, so 33 into 2 is 66. Now 63 into 5. So first we write 5 here, then 63 separated into 10s and 1 is 60 and 3. Okay, 60 and 3. Now when you do 5 into 60, 5 into 6 is 5 6 is 30 plus 1 0 300 and 5 3s are 15. So 315. So we'll do 300 plus 15, how much is that? 315. Okay, then D1, here we have 3, correct, and then here we separate this as 100, then this will be 20 and this will be 7. Okay, so 3 into 100 will be how much? 3 into 100 will be 300. Okay, and 3 into 20, 3 2s are 6 and the 0, 60, and 3 7s is how much? 3 7s is 21. Okay, so that will be 300 plus 60 plus 21. So how much is the answer? It will be, when you add all that, you'll get 381 as the answer. Alright, so this was question 1. So you can do question E and F for your homework. Okay, solve question E and F for homework. Now here, find the products. Now this is the second method. So 23 into 3. So first we'll multiply 3 into 3 ones. So that is 3 into 3 is how much? 3 3s are 9. And then we'll do 3 into 2. 3 2s is how much? 3 2s is 6. So 69. Okay, that is 69. Then B1. 34 into 2. So first we'll multiply 2 with 4. 2 4s is how much? 2 4s is 8. And then we'll multiply 2 with 3. 2 3s are how much? 2 3s are 6, which is 68. Okay, so 34 into 2 is 68. Then 41 into 5. 5 1s are 5. 5 4s are 20. So we'll write 2 0. So 205. 41 into 5 is 205. Then 121 into 4. 4 into 1 ones is 4 ones. So we'll write 4 in ones place. Then 4 into 2 tens is how much? 8 tens. So we'll write 8 in tens place. Then 4 into 1 hundreds is 4. So 4 hundreds, we'll write 4 in hundreds place. So 121 into 4 is 484. Okay, then 639 into 9. Now 9 into 9 ones. How much is 9 9s? 9 9s is 81. So we'll write 8 here and carry over. Sorry, we'll write 1 and carry over 8. Then 9 3s is how much? 9 3s is 27. So we'll write 7. What you do is 27 plus 8. 27 plus 8 is 28. 27 plus 8 is 35. Okay, 27 plus 8 is 35. So write 5 here and carry over 3. 9 6 are 54. 54 plus 3 is 57. So 5 7 5 1 is the answer. Okay, then last problem, 412 into 8. 8 2s is how much? 8 into 2 1s is 16 1s. So 6, regroup it, carry over 1 to 10's place. 8 into 1 is 8. 8 1s are 8 plus 1, 9. So we'll write 9 in 10's place. Then 8 4s is how much? 8 4s is 32. So we'll write 32 here. So the answer is 3296. Okay, 3296. So this is how you do multiplication. Now, okay, page number 129. In the next page, there are a few more questions. So let's solve that. 2321 into 3. So how do you do? First you do 3 into 1 1. So how much is that? 3 into 1, 3 1s is 3. So we write 3. Then 3 2s are how much? 3 into 2 is 6. So we'll write 6 in 10's place. Then 3 3s are 9. So we'll write 9 here. And then 3 2s is 6. So we'll write 6. So 6963 is the answer. Okay, so 2321 multiplied by 3 is 6963. Next one, 3438 into 2. So first we'll multiply 2 with 1. So we have 2 into 8 ones. So 2 into 8 ones is 16 ones. So we'll write 6 and carry over 1 to 10's place. Now we'll multiply 2 with 3 tens. 2 into 3 is 6. 6 plus 1 is how much? It is 7. So we write 7. Then 2 4s are. How much is 2 4s are? 2 4s are is 8. Okay. And then we'll do 2 into 1000's place. 2 3s are is 6. So we'll write 6. So 3438 into 2 is 6876. Alright. Now C1. 3028 into 9. So first we'll multiply 9 with 8 ones. How much is 8 9s are? Or 9 8s are? 9 8s are 72. So we'll write 2 here and carry over 7. So let's do that again. Sorry. So 9 8s are how much? 9 8s are 72. So we'll write 2 here and carry over 7 to 10's place. Now 9 2s are 18. How much? 9 2s are 18. And 18 plus 7 when you do, you'll get 25. So we'll write 5 and carry over 2 to 100's place. Now 9 zeros are, we know property of 0. Whenever you multiply a number by 0, you get 0 only. So 9 zeros are 0 plus 2 is 2. So 0 plus 2 is 2. So we'll write 2. Then 9 threes are how much? It is 27. So 3028 into 9 is 27,252. Okay. Then last question, 4281 into 7. Now 7 into 1 ones is 7 only. 7 ones are 7. Then 7 into 8 tens. 7 8s is how much? 7 8s is 56. So we'll write 6, carry over 5. Okay. Then 7 2s are 14. 14 plus 5, how much? It is 19. So we'll write 9, carry over 1. Okay. Then 7 4s are 28. 28 plus 1, 29. So that is 29,967. So 4,281 into 7 is 29,967. Okay, so this is how you do multiplication of numbers by one digit. Numbers are one digit multipliers. Okay, so now in the next class we will do multiplication by two digit numbers. Okay, we'll do multiplication by two digit numbers. For your homework, do the E and F question over here on this page. These two questions which they have given for at home. Then here also the questions that they have given for at home. Question number 1, E and F. Question number 2, G and H. So So complete these 1, 2, 3, 4, and in the next place, these page, these two questions, 5 and 6 problems for your homework. We'll continue in the next class. All right, thank you.